Hello everyone, it is finally time for me to look at the A-frame cabin. I've been extraordinarily busy over the past few days, which is why I wasn't able to get to this on the day of its unveiling. I think on that day in particular, over the 24-hour period, I did 4 live streams between YouTube and Patreon and, of course, Twitch. One of those was, well, a couple of those were some pretty important and very successful, thanks to so many of you viewers, charity fundraising streams. Yeah, this had to take a back seat. I also got some reviews done recently over on my LEGO Reviews channel. So this is the official thing, $179 or $80 US, and it comes out on February the 1st for VIPs, which means anybody, because anybody can be a VIP, as long as you're, 18 and up, something like that, it's a free account. 2,082 pieces for this. First impression, the cabin looks really nice. And I immediately see the butterflies that are printed, and I see the moth that's printed, moths that are printed, and the dark orange colored canoe over here, and another otter, and good colors for foliage pieces, but I also see these trees that don't look so good to me. That tree design does not look so good to me at all. This one over here on the left, that works. Actually, with those colors, you know, as something that's supposed to be a fall tree that's maybe lost a third of its foliage by now or something. But these ones over on the right, including the fall one, you know, the one that's fully green and the one that's not, both of those, they don't work for me. But the cabin is so smooth. I'm glad it has some texture on it. Very glad they did not just go for 100% studless construction there. I applaud that very, very highly. And they still have the all-important row of Mjolnirs in there. That was absolutely key from the original design. Some of these are misaligned. This is my first time looking at this other than just that first picture. It's my first time actually getting in and looking at it carefully at all. It'll be my very first time in any way, shape, or form seeing other pictures. Oh, so the top half comes off as well. And there's an attic up there. I don't think I ever looked at the interior details of the original submission. This has, again, some studs out there, some places to put minifigures. Gosh, that is so beautiful. That moth. And I don't even like moths. But the butterflies? Nah, the butterflies are better. Those colors are good. I hope that they will continue to do more of those. More things like that. Obviously, squirrel. I have to call out the squirrel, even though squirrel is super obvious. I have to call it out. A little bit of hiking space over here is a little bit limited. Okay, this is what I really wanted to get to. Oh, wow, look at all this stuff around the back. Huh. Is that a battery backup? Oh, no, that's a jerry can. What am I talking about? This is a jerry can. Water collection. Oh, that's a towel. I see, it's the outdoor shower is what's going on here. So you got a towel over there, and then the soap and the shower. Got it. Oh, nice, I got the typewriter 1x2. Cheese slope in there, a little filing cabinet off to the side. There's a geode crystal inside. Nice details on the inside. I don't know if this bed is going to be able to hold 2 people. I hope that's a print for the drawing up above or the painting up above. If it's not, it's okay, but I would prefer it to be a print. These people obviously really like geology and geological artifacts. There's another gem over here or a crystal of some sort. This stuff, oh, that's interesting. That's an interesting idea. Look at that. The side bits, this over here and this over here, can be combined, it looks like, or is it just the part on the top? Let me go back to that. Does include the firewood, a little storage area. Good. I like it. Interesting mushrooms, a little bit different. Yeah, this works better for me. Bringing more of the foliage together. It's just so sparse when it's by itself. Canoe, got the realistic acoustic guitar once again. 2 colors of birds. This is the first time we've ever gotten 2 colors of birds in a single set. So we got the blue, which is actually a dark azure, and the relatively rare red one also. Frog is frog. 2 figures with dual molded legs. Good. All these prints look nice. That one's common. Is this one we've had before here, right there? I think it's new also. New map piece, that's good. I wonder what exactly this represents. There are probably some hints, some connections to some other sets in there as well. It's decently sizable. Oh, I like the size. I like the presence of it. Oh, it's really good. This could actually look good in a modern decor space, as well as a, oh God. As well as something more naturalistic, and it's back in the bunker. Look at this. Look at this abomination here. It's not even the raw, brutalist concrete that's bugging me with this one this time. It's whatever this is. Did they take like some mortar and spread it on a canvas and then put it in a frame? Is that the fashion now? Oh, that's bad. it's the treehouse. It's a little miniature version of the treehouse. Very nice. Very cool. Ooh, the messenger bag in dark blue. Spider in the attic. The point of these videos is not for me to point out every single thing that's on the screen that you can see. I do tend to find myself needing to do exactly that, though, because if I don't, most of the comments, unfortunately, are ignoring the entire video, but just focusing on, Jang, did you see that one thing at that 1 second? Yes, we all saw that. How do you like the set? I like the set a lot. Again, the trees detract from it. This thing has really good presence, nice amount of wildlife in it, a little bit of configurability. Let's see the proper marketing video for it, though. Gotta turn off their music. Ignoring the background, just focusing on the set here to the best of my ability. That's a lot of foliage pieces. That's good. It just sits in there too, huh? It doesn't even clip, which is good. It's simple. Yeah, that looks so good. Ah, from all angles. I don't like the exposed Technic holes for the little modular area on the base. That's easy enough to cover up. Yeah, it really looks good against many different backgrounds. That's a surprise. I thought it would look best amongst wood and trees and plants and house plants and things like that. $180 for 2,000, almost 2,100 pieces. Makes sense on paper for the size of the thing. Relative to the minifigures, I don't know. It seems kind of small to me. It's very dense, but it seems small. It's probably going to be heavier than it looks. But the size just isn't there for me. It's too bad. I think the value is not the greatest, but the set is good, with the one exception, that tree in particular. That one a little bit too, but especially this one. And those are totally correctable. So all in all, I am happy with what I see here. I hope that I will have a chance to purchase it and build it and review it. I do have to focus on trying to get back to working on the city, which I've been doing on a regular basis. On Twitch and Patreon, need to get back to doing update videos. So we'll see. I'm not going to commit to buying and reviewing this yet, but I would like to. We'll see how the rest of this month works out until the release of this on February the 1st. Thank you for watching. This was a relatively long and more casual look at the thing, but it's because I've got a moment right now with a couple of other videos that are presently rendering or uploading over on the LEGO Reviews channel. So I wanted to just chill about it. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon. Lots more to come. My button's not working.